Today we're speedrunning through Slime Rancher, but this time we're breaking the entire game. And you'll see how we do that in just a second. First of all, I am going to make a new game, and we're not going to start our timer until we're done with this loading screen. It's going to give us this whole spiel, you know, normal Slime Rancher things. And as soon as we spawn in, once we can start moving, we want to start our timer, go in here, and then move our mouse over there, escape, and press space so we sleep until the morning. And then we have this menu overloaded effect where, yeah, you can see what's happening now. So we're going to want to move over there, use our emergency return, escape after that, then sleep until the morning one more time before finally returning to the ranch, and you can kind of see what effect is going to happen. This is called sleepwalking, because the game just constantly thinks that we're asleep, and that allows us to do a lot of cool things. First of all, it's always going to make new vegetables and fruits, so you can kind of just keep taking them and not worrying about getting new ones. And then it also will make a ton of new slime, so we basically just get tons of things and don't even have to try for it. I'm going to come over here, get a couple more of these pogo fruits, and then we can take it to our first big slime, feed him really quick, and this is going to give us our first key. Of course, we do have to get 5 keys and unlock 5 doors before we can finish the game. So then we're also gonna platform up here because we do need a Q-berry for later. I'm gonna platform right there, get one of these Q-berries, and finally get our first key right there. And yeah, now we just pretty much have a running section, but it is the perfect time to explain. This is the effect. It is such a cool thing. Now you do constantly hear this ticking sound, which does kind of get annoying, but that is just part of the glitch and you can't really do too much about it. And this glitch can only be done on older versions of Slime Rancher, so I actually had to use an older version. The version I'm on is 1.2.0. And yeah, you can do some pretty cool stuff with it, as you see. With these slimes, they're just gonna constantly be making new ones. I'm gonna have to get rid of those pink plorts because I want one of these rock plorts so I can feed this pink slime it. And then we also want one more rock plort if we can find it. I don't know what's going on. Okay, we're just gonna leave. I'll get this pink slime and take him with us. He is not looking too happy, or maybe he's satisfied. I don't really know what that look on his face is. But what we can do with this guy is we're gonna take him over to this wall and kind of just jump off of him so he can make it to the top. Okay, that one did not feel like working. But we'll try this one more time. We can jump off the pink slime. Beautiful jump. And yeah, you can pretty much see what this game is all about. Just cheesing through the entire thing. I mean, it is a speedrun. What do you really expect? So now what we want to do is we need a ton of these Oka Okas because we're going to get to our next big slime. And that looks like enough. So then we can make our way over here and get to this radioactive big slime, which we're going to feed him some Oka Okas and some carrots. So he's going to eat a ton of those. And then hopefully he's going to be done. Please stop eating, dude. You've eaten so much already. He'll explode. We can get our second key, make our way over here. And now it's time for a tiny bit of a grinding section. Pretty much for this, all we want is a bunch of this stuff from the green slimes. We want as many rad plorts as possible, so we're just gonna let them keep eating. It's a never-ending supply of food, so it's kind of amazing. And yeah, they're just gonna keep giving us more rad plorts, which are gonna be able to sell for a bunch. I'm also gonna make sure that I can get one of these blue plorts as well, so we can have that for later. And we need about 18 of these rad plorts, so I just need a couple of more, and we can be on our way. So you can see, already, we've gotten so much stuff. The game is just continuously going between day and night, so you never have to worry about waiting. It just makes this game so much fun. I mean, the effect is cool too. We can go right back here and then we can start selling some stuff. So I'm going to take them over here and we want to keep at least one of our rad plorts. So I'm going to be kind of careful with that just to make sure I don't actually sell it. We'll get a garden and we'll make a Q-berry garden. And finally, we'll use the money that we got to get a jetpack, dash boots, and a tank booster. And now another amazing part about this is as soon as I get rid of these Oka Okas, we just get tons of Q-berries. They're just going to continuously fall off of this tree because we're constantly going through day and night. It's amazing. So we're going to want about 30 of those and then we can move on. Skipping past through pretty much everything you're supposed to do in Slime Rancher. Usually you're supposed to, you know, make a farm and do things like that. But that seems like a lot of work. So instead, I just kind of feel like running through it. I mean, if the days and nights are going to go this fast, I might as well. It's kind of funny to see all the slimes appear then disappear too. It makes this game really weird. And an annoying thing about this run is the plorts will disappear really fast if you're not careful about it. So every time we see a plort, we just have to make sure we get it right away. Otherwise, the night is going to cause it to go away. So along with these guys, we're going to get a couple of these phosphor ports. And we get to the next cool part about this run, which is the infinite jetpack. Because time is moving so fast, our jetpack is just going to constantly be getting refilled, and then we can just keep using it. So I'm just going to jetpack my way up there, make my way through here. Yeah, we don't really have to do any platforming at all. We can just jetpack through. And here is the coolest part of the run, because literally what you can do is you can stand on this rock, and now we just jetpack across this entire ocean. Because we're never running out of our jetpack, we just keep moving, and yeah, this is gameplay. So we make it over here, we don't have to worry about any of that stuff, and we can come over here, get rid of this phosphor slime that I have there, and get a couple of mint mangoes because we're gonna need them in just a second. We're gonna need about 27 mint mangoes, so I'm just gonna kind of fly up here and hope they come into my vacuum. Come on, guys, hurry up, let's do this already. And it seems like we almost have enough. Just need a couple more of these mint mangoes. Come on, game, let them fall already. I'm not trying to wait forever. And then we can fly up up here with our mint mangoes and make our way to this guy, which we can start feeding. This guy, of course, is going to explode, give us another key. You know, this is just kind of needed. And then we can come down here, get one of these honey plorts. Okay, I didn't want the honey slime. No, thank you. Please give me a plort. Come on, game. This is annoying. Let me get that honey plort. Oh, but this guy's already made. Never mind. But we're actually going to get this guy because we needed the honey plort to make one of the boom slimes into this guy, but I guess this works too. And yeah, the annoying thing about carrying these guys is they're just constantly in your way. But whatever, guess you gotta deal with it if you wanna go fast. So we're gonna move this guy all the way over here. We can do some more cool movement with our jetpack. Or can I really call it movement, or is it just like cheesing through the entire game? And we can shoot him over there, make our way up here. And then this is the point when we're just gonna get a ton of hens. So these hens are gonna constantly be getting because of the day-night cycle, so you can just see them more and more, and right when they're born, I steal them. Yeah, you guys are getting eaten. I don't really care about your lives. Sorry, Briar Hens. It's just part of life, I guess. This pink slime is also trying to get in here, but I don't really want you, dude. I just want a couple more Briar Hens. We need about 27, and we'll be safe. Come on, just give me a couple more. Game, I really need this. Oh, they're all hiding beneath here. Come on, dude. Okay, and now what I want to do is I want to take one of these tabby slimes, which we don't have enough slots, so we kind of have to move it like this, where we're using our vacuum to give it momentum, and then we can make it keep coming. Come on, tabby. Yeah, this movement is always so weird, but then we can take our next key, make it go through here, take this boom slime, and we're gonna shoot the boom slime over there, move the tabby just a little bit more. I do not know where it went. Okay, it's over there. And now we get to the point where we're gonna put all of our plorts in their necessary places. We're also gonna unlock this door because you do need to unlock 5 doors if you want to complete the game. Then we can put the rad plort there. Okay, it did not feel... How did I miss that shot? Okay, we'll try that again. We'll not miss that shot that time. We'll come over here, feed this guy one of these, get both the honey and the boom plorts. Okay, move out of the way, dude. And now we can put the honey in there. There should be the tabby somewhere around here. I don't know where this tabby felt like going. Where are you? Okay, there we go. Now we can feed it a hen. Get the tabby plort as well, and then we can move the boom plort over here. Come on, game. I'm just trying to go fast. We only need the tabby now, and then we can open up this door and make it to the final section of the game. So now we have kind of a long cutscene where we just have to wait for this door to finish up. Come on, door. I know you can do it. I believe in you. I'm just gonna try to fly. And because I have an infinite jetpack, I might be able to sneak my way through there. Thank you very much. That's gonna save us just a tiny bit of time, but hey, I'll take it. And now we're at a point of where I don't need any of this stuff anymore, except for the Briar Hens. Because the Briar Hens are gonna be used in just 1 second. I just have to do a quick bit of platforming right there, make my way into this place so we can take care of one last one of these big slimes. And yeah, this guy needs to be fed 25 Briar Hens so we can just let him eat. He seems pretty happy, even though he's about to explode and die. Sorry about that, man. So we get his final key, and that is the last key that we're going to need. Try to make our way through this, but all these slimes are around here. And we get into this area where we're going to want to get some more plorts because we're going to need 5 quantum plorts to move on to the next area. Come on, I just need a couple more, guys. Just give me them. We have 4. Just one more of you eat. And there we go. That should be 5. As soon as it makes that, we can move on with our lives. And it's time for another platforming section where we don't do any platforming at all because instead we're just going to jetpack our way over there. This is just a beautiful game, isn't it? And at this point, we don't need any of this stuff. Like, I don't need the pogo fruit. I don't need the tabby slimes. I don't even really need the quantum slimes, but we will have the quantum plorts because those are going to be important right here. Because these are necessary to get onto the final section. I can just put all of these quantum plorts in these guys' mouths. And then this is going to cause this entire thing to happen. We just have to wait a second before we can go in there. And yeah, now we're on the final section. And a funny thing about this final section is during the day-night cycle, you're just going to constantly see, like, meteors pounce on the ground. So, like, look at all these explosions that are just constantly happening over here. It's kind of hilarious. But I'll make some platforming to jetpack over there, make my way over here. I just love having my infinite jetpack. It makes this game so much easier when you don't have to actually do anything. And yeah, pretty much the rest of this speedrun is kind of just running. It's the normal path you usually have to take. We can make our way over to this door because we still have one extra key. And yeah, we'll just kind of make it there eventually. I'll use my slime key right there. It's smiling, having a good time. We're gonna make our way down over here. We see some slimes that get made and then instantly die. Yeah, I feel bad for all the slimes in this game because a lot of them just get made and then die or they overpopulate. But I guess they also have infinite food, so it isn't too much of a problem. But here we go. We're almost at the end. I just kind of have to walk over here, make my way through these explosions. And we're about to get to the final point where we can see this glitch, the beautiful moon, all those things like that. But I'm gonna walk over here, make our way to this final message. And I can just click on this. It's going to save my game. And then I can exit out of the game, which is also when we pause our timer, and then we can go back into Slime Rancher, so I'm just kind of loading back in. None of this part counts for the speedrun. It does pause during this loading screen, because you can't access your menu at all when you're in that glitch, so you do have to completely exit out of the game. We're just gonna wait, then we can go continue, and then as soon as we get back in the game, I'm going to start my timer again, so I just have to wait 1 second, and there we go, I can start my timer, we can do an emergency return, and there we go. We get knocked out, all that kind of thing, but it doesn't matter, because we already finished the game. Well, kind of, because we also have to do everybody's favorite part of this game, going and reading all your mail. If you want to finish this game, you have to read a ton of mail, so we kind of just have to sit here and keep sleeping till the morning, because normally when you play this game, you know, you're not going to have this entire stockpile of mail. You're going to read it as you go through, but for us, we kind of just have to keep sleeping. Yeah, this is definitely the best part of the speedrun. Everybody loves this part. And I guess I'll just get back to you once we're on the last mail. Hopefully we'll get there soon. We're actually really close to a sub 15. I really need this to hurry up if we want to get this. Oh, we're really losing the sub 15 because of the mail. This is amazing. But I believe that should be the last message right there. Okay, it wasn't. I guess I was wrong. I just love losing time. Yeah, there are so many mail messages that you're just kind of not sure. I think we actually have two more now that I'm thinking about it. So there's this one last one right there, and then hopefully we can exit out of here and end off time, and there's our time, 1525, which, hey, that actually went pretty well. I mean, it wasn't perfect, but I'm pretty happy with that time. And if we look on speedrun.com, we'll see that it wasn't the greatest in the world, but we didn't get last. There's only a small amount of people who've done this, and it's pretty competitive, so I'm happy with what I got. But I'd like to thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like on it. It really helps me with the YouTube algorithm, and I'd really appreciate it. Also, check out my other videos. I do a lot of speedrunning type content on this channel that you might enjoy, and if you do, subscribe. We're getting really close to 1 million subscribers, so I would really appreciate it. But enough shilling. Thank you all for watching. I'll catch you next time.